might be wondering why I'm sitting down. I have cerebral palsy, a physical disability that affects the way my brain communicates with my muscles. Now, you might be wondering what my life is like, so here's my perspective on a typical school day. I wake up and turn on the lamp beside my bed. Oftentimes, it doesn't come on the first time I try it. So I slow down. I tell myself, that pinch push, it comes on. I get dressed with some assistance to make sure everything is tucked in and nothing is twisted. Then I put on my shoes and tie them like this. I eat breakfast in the car on my way to school. Then my dad walks me in and drops me off with my paper festival. The place in the afternoon find moments as such as writing down my homework. Then I get my root tube and my cart and off we head to my gifted free calculus class. Even though it's a math class, and writing is hard for me, I'm successful because I have a great math program on the computer that allows me to type in my work and have it come out and actually look like math. Then we leave 5 minutes early to go to my AP US History class, which is in the trailers. This can cause quite a few problems. One, there's a thing there that goes up to the trailer, and since the stairs aren't wide enough for all the kids to come down, they often come down too. And the ramp is barely wide enough for my wheelchair, so this means one of us has to stop for the other one to go and use the ramp. Secondly, when it rains, my parents and I don't have enough hands to get an umbrella, so we have to dump onto and go out. After ABU assisted, I eat lunch, then go to Latin class, then American Lit, then physics, then drama. After school, I come home, do my homework, go to therapy, eat dinner, and go to bed. When I'm not at school, I love to travel. But I realize something. People in small beach towns don't have as much experience with people with disabilities as people in big cities such as Atlanta. Often, I'm treated differently there, such as in restaurants, the waiter or waitress often says, good job, when I'm done ordering. And I'm just sitting there thinking, hey, I can order just as well as any other of your customers. Treat me as such. When I'm not traveling or at school, I am doing a summer camp that my parents run. It's an intensive therapy camp, which allows me to get so much stronger. It was here where I first learned about the conditions for children with disabilities in orphanages. At lunch, the person who leads my camp told me that that she doesn't see people with disabilities employed in Eastern Europe as widely as she does here in the U.S. I was interested, so I went online and tested children with disabilities in Russia. I was shocked at what I saw. So the feedback at least two wheelchairs can go all that time. That way, no one will have to experience the waves. If you're in the hospitality industry, treat all customers the same. And if you are a teacher, I encourage you today, take a special education class. It will come in handy, no matter what you plan on teaching. And if you're looking at having kids, I urge you to go adopt a child with a disability from an orphanage in a developing country. Go, untie them from the crib and give them the life they deserve. And if you're interested in donating to this cause, lead us in charity that are helping to close orphanages and lessen the cost of adoption.